Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am sharing it's kind of like a September's favorite, but I know we're already like at the end of October, so it's kind of like my current fall favorites video. I have quite a few products that I want to show you, including some stuff that I've just been loving, such as TV shows or even movies. So I'm definitely have a little bit more than I did in my August favorites video. But before we jump in, I just want to let you guys know, if you aren't already subscribed to my channel, please hit that big red subscribe button down below. Also, so you get notified whenever I upload a new video, please hit that bell notification down below so you can get notified whenever I do post a new one. And also, if you do enjoy this video and you do enjoy watching favorites videos, please click the thumbs up button so I can know that you like this video. So without further ado, we're just going to jump right into it. So I'm going to start out with beauty products because I have a couple that I want to show you guys. It's not too much because I've been trying to like change like my makeup routine lately. I'm trying not to wear too much makeup, but when I do, these are some of like the basic products that I go for. Some of them you have seen in like my Vlogtober videos that I've been doing on my channel, and also some you might have seen in the summer when I was doing some makeup tutorials, so they might be a little bit of a repeat, but I just never really talked in depth about them, so that's what I'm going to do today for you guys. So the first product is this NYC Smooth Skin Bronzing Face Powder, and this is an old school product for me because I've been using this since I was like in 8th grade, and I'm surprised that they still make it, but it's one of the best like non-shimmer matte bronzing powders, and it's such a cool tone color, which I really really love, especially for the fall and winter when I'm a little bit more fair than I usually am. And I just use this all over my face, mainly all over my cheeks, my chin, and just to contour my nose lightly because I don't really do like harsh contouring, so this really really does like a natural contour for me. And I just love that it has no shimmer in it. It's such a nice color. My skin, you can't really tell, but you can build it up if you want to, but I just do it lightly so you kind of have a little bit of a definition. But this only runs for about $3 or $4 from the drugstore, and it is such great quality that I actually have like 2 more backups of it just in case. But I really really like this, and I just use like a flat kabuki brush and I just blend it to my skin. And it looks so, so beautiful. So I definitely recommend this if you're looking for a cheap bronzer that is no shimmer, between a warm and a cool tone, and very affordable. The next product is a Fenty Beauty product, which I actually featured in a makeup tutorial I did in the summer, which I'll probably link up here. And this is the Kilowatt Foil Highlighter Duo in Mimosa Sunrise and Sangria Sunset. So this is just how the packaging looks. I don't know if you guys can really tell, but inside it just has this beautiful burnt orange color and this beautiful shimmery fuchsia color. And as you can see, they kind of like have a, I don't know, like a highlighted look to them because they are highlighters. But lately I've been using the orange one, the Mimosa Sunrise, on my cheeks as a blush. And I just really, really, really like it. It just adds that a little bit more of like a highlighted blush color to my cheeks. And I know you will wear sort of like this color in the spring or summer, but I've been trying to wear it in the fall, and I just think that it looks really really pretty. It really complements like my skin tone, helps to warm it up, as well as adding some color to my cheeks. This I actually got from Sephora when it came out. It's around $30, which is a little bit expensive, but I think it's really worth it for these unique colors that I haven't really seen. And you can also use these as highlighters, which is what they're for a blush or even as eyeshadow. So they work a ton of different ways, and it's such great packaging as well. But I really love this product, and I've been like rocking it all week, and I don't know, I just really love the colors. Like, you would think that these aren't fall colors, but they actually are, with the orange and even the fuchsia pink. It's really really nice, so I really enjoy this product. Now for a more drugstore affordable highlighter that I've been loving, this is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder, and I believe it is Precious Petals. And it's just this like, mine kind of broke, but it's just this like champagne-y pink color, and it gives the most beautiful highlight. Now I don't really go too crazy on my highlight, but I don't know if you can tell on my nose, it kind of has some, and kind of on my cheekbones. It's just such a natural highlighting color, and I didn't realize that the pink would actually complement my skin tone very well, but it looks really really pretty. And this was, I believe, about $5, maybe cheaper, I'm not exactly sure, but I've had this since the summer and I still haven't hit pan yet, and I've been using it like every day, but it's just so, so beautiful and creamy. And you can build it up, or you could just even keep it natural like I do. And I even wear this on my inner corners, on my eyelids. Once again, I love using the highlighters as like multiple things, as like highlighting or even as eyeshadow. Same thing for blush and bronzers. I like to really utilize my products, but I really, really love this highlighter. It's so beautiful, such a nice color, so creamy, and really, really affordable. So the next two products, which are also from Wet n Wild, these are recent ones that I got, and if you guys watch my Vlogtober videos, you would see that I did buy these during that time. And these are just the Wet n Wild Megalass Liquid Catsuit Matte Lipsticks. As you see, I have two colors here. I actually have one more, but I don't wear that one as often because it is like a fuchsia, like a dark fuchsia color. So these are more for natural colors. The first color I have is in Give Me Mocha, which is just like this burnt reddish color, which is really nice if you want to have more of a darker lip, but also great for layering. And then the one that I'm actually wearing today on my lips, which is just like a nudie pink color, which I really, really love, is in Rebel Rose, and it's just like this mauvey purple natural lip color. And when you put these on, they feel like lip gloss, but like a really smooth lip gloss, like they don't dry completely when you first put it on, which makes it so easy to really like glide on your lips. And then they dry to a little bit of a darker color. So when you first put this one on, it's a little bit of a light color. But once it dries to this beautiful, like matte pink, mauvey color. And they're not too dry. And if you put at least one layer on, your lips don't feel super dry. You can move your lips. It doesn't feel like it's cracking on top of your lips. And it's just a really beautiful color, as well as this one. I really recommend them. These are about $5, which is kind of like the price of the ColourPop lipsticks, which I think is really affordable. But they are such great quality. I definitely recommend to check these out. I just picked them up on a whim, and I'm so happy that I did, because they're so, so beautiful. And these colors are to die for. They also have like a black and a blue one that I want to get, but I don't know if I'm that brave to pull them off yet. But definitely check these out if you have Wet n Wild selling at your nearby drugstore, because they are so worth it. So those are all my beauty products. I do have one healthy product that I want to show you guys. Well, it's actually pretty healthy. I also share this in my Vlogtober videos. If you guys haven't checked out my Vlogtober videos, which I'm currently still doing, you can check them out. They are on this channel. And I do share like mini hauls on there. So some of these products you might have seen already, but if you haven't, you can also check out those videos to just see when I picked them up and a little bit more of what I talked about. But these are the VitaFusion Women's Supercharged Multivitamins for energy, metabolism, bone, and immune support. And the reason I got this is because at one point, like a month ago, I was feeling really, really tired throughout the day. Every morning I would wake up and just feel super tired. I wouldn't even be drinking coffee the day before or anything. And I always wonder, like, why am I so tired? And I also felt like really down at the same time, and I think it was because the weather was starting to change and like it would start to get a little bit more dark earlier, because we're getting into the fall season. Well, it is already fall, but it's getting into that winter colder months, and I just need some more energy. And I decided to pick this up, which I just found on Amazon. And this has, I think it's B12 that really helps with like helping you to stay awake and stuff. And I would take two of these every morning, and I would feel just like, not super energized, but I would feel like fine. Even it will just boost my energy, and like I would feel a little bit more like on the happier side, if that makes any sense. And not feeling like down and tired and drained. And the good thing about this is, since I do just eat two in the morning, by the time it's nighttime and I wake up the next day, I don't feel completely drained. Like, it doesn't give you too much energy where you'll wake up and just feel completely dead and drained, because that's how it goes for like coffee for me. If I drink like a ton of coffee, it makes me feel great throughout the day, but when I wake up the next day, I feel even more tired than I did the day before. So this helps to not do that, but still give you enough energy that you need throughout the day. As you can see, I'm almost running low, but I still have quite a lot left. This comes with 150 gummies. I think it was about $15, maybe less, I'm not sure, but I'll definitely leave the link down below. But this has helped me so much. Of course, I do forget to take some of them because I'm always running late in the morning. But when I feel like I need them for the day, I'm definitely gonna make sure to take them. But they're really great, and they really help me quite quite a lot. So if you're suffering with like tiredness or anything, definitely recommend to check these out. So I'm gonna move into some fashion items, and the first one, which you guys seen recently, and I've only got to wear it once, but I already love it so much. This is just my cheetah print bag from Topshop, which I love so much. It's just this fuzzy pink leopard print. Well, I said cheetah print. I don't know which one it is, but when I search on the website, it says leopard. Leopard print bag. Has this beautiful strap, this great silver hardware that feels very sturdy. You open the flap and then it has a zipper compartment inside. And this is just the most coziest bag that I've ever had. Like, it feels so great. Such a great length of a strap. Has so much room in it, and it's just such a great detail. Reminds me of like my tween years when I was like 12 and I went to wear like these cute little stuff to like middle school and stuff. But it's just so cute and adorable. I've been seeing so many girls rock these leopard print bags recently. Always wondering where they got them from, and surprisingly they're all from Topshop. But I'm so happy I picked this up. It was about $50, which might be a lot. I'm not sure, depending on how much you would spend on a handbag. But for this, it feels like really great quality, so I felt fine splurging on it, and I don't know, I just always wanted one like this, so I didn't mind spending $50 on them. But it feels like great quality, like it's gonna last a long time, and I just really like it. Hopefully it's still in stock, because I know they kind of sell out of this print really fast, but if it is, I'll leave a link down below. These next items are a pair of shoes / sneakers, and they are a pair that I actually bought the beginning of this year, and I've only worn them like once before now, basically. But you would think that I wouldn't really break these out during the fall time because of the color, but one day I just put them on and I just realized they match so many of my outfits that I've been wearing, because I wear a lot of neutral tones. As you guys can tell, I'm wearing like this beige looking sweater, which actually matches these shoes. But these are my Air Max. I always forget the number of my sneakers. Please don't kill me if you are a sneakerhead, but I'll probably have it on the screen or in the description below. But I believe these are the Igloo colorway. Not really sure. Don't know if it's picking up my camera because it does look a little bit bright, but they're just like these dad looking shoes, and they have like the air bubbles on the bottom in this like Igloo blue icy color. And the toe just looks like that, just looks really, you know, I don't know, sporty. And I just really love the color of them. Like, I don't know, I feel like they match my fall outfits because they are like a neutral tone. And like a cream, like cookies and cream color. That's kind of what they remind me of, like cookies and cream, which is one of my favorite chocolates. Flavors or ice cream flavor, I don't know, but I really like these. They're super comfortable to walk in, of course, because they are Air Max. I don't remember how much I spent on these, probably quite a lot, like $120, because I got them when they first came out. But I think they're worth it now that I'm starting to get used to how to style them. So that's why I really enjoy them now, because I've been like, the first day that I wore them again, I got so many compliments from people like, oh, I really love those sneakers, or I've never seen you wear them, like they're so nice. So I'm like, wow, maybe I should wear them more often. But I really do like these shoes, super comfortable. Like, if I could wear sneakers to work every day, I definitely would, because they're the only thing that makes my feet feel comfortable. Like, wearing boots annoy me so much. Like, I've been wearing my Doc Martens lately, and it's just been like killing me how heavy they are and just uncomfortable. But once I put these on, I can like run a mile in like 10 seconds with these. So I definitely do love these sneakers. I love Air Max so much, and I will definitely keep on rocking them for the rest of the season. So now getting into the more, I guess you would say, like TV shows and books and stuff. I have one book to share, which is also one of my favorite horror / thriller movies. And this is Stephen King's The Shining. Now I'm pretty sure a lot of you know what The Shining is. I'm pretty sure most of you have seen it. And if you haven't, where have you been living underneath a rock? Because this is a great movie. Now, I have kind of a bad thing to say for the movie, because since I've been reading this, which I haven't finished, I have quite a few pages left to go, but I read like half. But so far reading this, I feel like I love the book a little bit more than the movie. Of course, the movie brings like visually, you can see how everything looks. So it gives me that kind of mood of like a fall winter movie that I just love a lot. But reading the book just adds so much information so many different scenes that were not even taken place where they were in the book. And I kind of wish that it was filmed just like the book, which now I understand why Stephen King kind of didn't like the way that Stanley Kubrick filmed the movie and how he did it. But this is a really great book. I'm so happy that I'm reading it. I thought it was going to be too much like the movie, so I feel like kind of would have been a waste to read it, but I'm so happy that I did. I have it on paperback and I also have it on my phone. I read it more often on my phone, so it's kind of hard to go back to the book and find out where I left off on my phone, but my phone I'm always carrying with me on the train. But this is such a great book. It just shows so much more in depth with all the characters, like with Danny and Jack and Wendy, rather than just showing just the scary parts of the movie and just the scary things happening, and kind of goes into more background of why they're like the way they are. So that's what I really like about this book. Definitely read it if you've never read it before and then watch the movie, I'd say, because I kind of wish I read this first then watched the movie. Because no, actually I do like the way I did it, because watching the movie first and then reading this is like, oh my gosh, why didn't they add that? Or it's like, you go back and say like, wow, that really happened in the movie, and it's weird like reading that, like that's exactly how it felt. So definitely check this out. The paperback was only, I believe, like $6 on Amazon, so a really great price. And I had to say that Stephen King is probably one of my favorite authors, because I just brought like two more books from him, and I've just been reading them like crazy, and I just love these thriller kind of like scary, weird sort of movies and books by him. So it's definitely a great book. Please check it out. And the last two things I'm going to share are two TV shows I've been loving right now. The first one is going to be Castle Rock, and this is just a show about a prison where I don't really know, actually, because I'm still kind of confused on it. I'm only on episode 3. I do love it a lot, but it's just been taking me a while to watch it because I've just been having so much going on. But it's just a show about a prison, and they find this boy that's in the prison in some basement, just locked down there like an inmate, and they're kind of confused on why. And just this whole town that Castle Rock is at, strange things happen to people where they kill themselves for some reason, not sure why. And then it follows this lawyer, and he's trying to help this boy, trying to figure out like why was he in this prison, like locked down there. I don't know, it's just a really great TV show. I definitely recommend it. It's also based off of some Stephen King novels, so that's probably why I also like it. But it's on Hulu, so if you have Hulu, definitely check it out, because it's a really great, really nice like horror thriller type of show, but then also like drama. So I really, really like that TV show. And another TV show that everyone has been talking about, and that you guys know I've been talking about in my blogtubers, is The Haunting of Hill House. And I actually finished that last night. I finished it in about 4 days, which is really fast for me, because as you guys know, I take quite a long time to finish TV shows. But I just finished that, and once it got up to like episode 5 and on, I was like, wow, like the way they put 2 and 2 together from the beginning of the show till the end, I was just like so shocked, like, oh my gosh, that's why that happened, or this is why that happened. Like, that show, it just became so, like, I don't know, it was so well put together. And I'm kind of confused trying to see if there's going to be a second season because of the way it ended, but it's really, really great. Definitely recommend to check it out if you have Netflix, because it's a really great show. And also going back to The Shining, the director is also creating a sequel to the Shining movie, so that's coming out, they said, I think in January of 2020. So I'm kind of excited to see that. It's on one of the books by Stephen King. I forgot what it's called, but it's based off of Danny Torrance's life as he's older, so after he grows up from The Shining. I think it's called Dr. Sleep, I think. But he's creating a movie, the director of Hill House. So now seeing Hill House, I'm like, I'm hoping it's gonna be really good, because I feel like Hill House kind of related to The Shining for me, like the way they made like the scary stuff happen. So I'm like, I think that's gonna be a really, really great movie, so I cannot wait for that. So those are all my favorites for this fall season. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I tried to involve as much stuff as I can, but hopefully I did pretty well compared to my previous ones. I only have like 3 items, but these are just some stuff that I've been loving recently. and hopefully for November, December, I'll have even more because it's going to be during the holidays and stuff, so I know a lot of things are going to be popping up. But I hope you guys do enjoy this video. Once again, I am doing Vlogtober on my channel, so if you guys haven't checked out those Vlogtober videos, didn't really catch up on them because they're on my channel and I've just been enjoying doing it lately, even though some of them are kind of boring, but I still hope that you guys check them out and enjoy them. But also, please hit that subscribe button down below, like I said, if you do enjoy my videos, and also give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. And I will see you guys in my next one. Bye! I'm